But without further ado, let's get back on the core bandwagon here. Okay. Ooh. Okay. How am I meant to do this with that? I got a dash there. I can do a second dash. Okay, and then maybe we can jump across the blocks. Okay. I've got to be quick though to get onto that block there. So I've got to do a really quick like turnaround on that second block. Almost like that. Ah! And then I dashed. I shouldn't have dashed. That was silly of me. I think it's because I was struggling to get that other block, but no, I think that's worked out, which is good. But it's about timing that dash after getting that stamina boost back to perfection. Yeah, I was too low. I need to get really high on that block to be able to pull this off. Oh man. So go up twice possibly and then... Okay. If I go up twice, jump over on the top one, and then dash to the other side. And I can't even do the first move. Jeez. Good going, Nock. That's fantastic. Also, get rid of that. I don't want to see that in the corner of my eye. It's really off-putting. Not that you guys know what I was talking about, but... Yeah, it was really off-putting. Something like that. Oh man, I grabbed too long though there. I lost my stamina really early. Why am I'm losing my stamina now? I don't understand why. Not getting enough height because of the lack of stamina. Go away, YouTube. I mean, hello, YouTube. How are you? Please never go away. I love you all. Fat fingered. So close. till I fat finger again. I got through the gap, and I wasn't expecting to get through the gap, so I was a little bit caught off guard there, I'll be honest. It's not good if I start losing my stamina before I've even got over this gap here. That's definitely not good. Such like a small window of opportunity there to hit that dash through that gap. And every time thumb is hurting pretty hard today as well, because I've played quite a lot of Celeste already today, like I said, in the build up to this. I've done my first complete run of the game in a timed capacity today, so my thumb's already taken a battering. We'll have to see how we go. Hopefully I can prolong it for a bit. I don't know what to do on that last one though, once I get up to the top. I think I've got to jump over it and then... It seems like the only reasonable and logical thing to do. I just need to be quicker in what I do. Be more accurate when I jump over this one. I wasn't expecting to get that. Oh! But yeah, that's it. We got it. Just need to execute now. Too low when I grab the stamina regen. Jump fractionally too early there as well. Quite impressed with my accuracy through these things now though. The spike's killing me. I At times like this, I wish I could play with the analog stick rather than the D-pad, because it would save my fingers no end. I kind of like fainted off that freaking thing there. Yes! Alright. New screen time. Whew. You've just missed the first screen, my man. Welcome along to the stream, though. We've been live and running for about 10 minutes now. So, yeah. How are you doing today? I did say at the beginning of the stream that I actually did my first complete run, my first complete timed run today of the main game. So, okay, I gotta save my dash. Sorry, I'm just waiting for my phone to go on to do not disturb at 10 o'clock, so I can turn it off do not disturb. That probably doesn't make much sense to a lot of people, but hey, I'll take that screen. That was a pretty good screen. Like second or third attempt. I'll take that. Oh, okay. So we've got to time this? Jeez. Four days off, nice. Yeah, I'm looking forward to this weekend as well. It's actually my birthday on Sunday, so going for Chinese tomorrow night with the wife and some friends. Should be really nice. Okay, so I think I can use my other dash there, actually. I just need to work out how long to delay for. So close. Jumped a little bit too early. I didn't jump off there, did I? Not tomorrow, my birthday on Sunday, but we're going out for birthday meal tomorrow. Excuse me. Oh man. That was massively bad on the port on the timing. Well, yeah, I don't know that I've got them down, but yeah, I know the mechanics of them at least. After your comments last night about the, when I was, you know, on the cloud stuff, doing the clouds. And, no need to apologise. Everybody misinterprets from time to time. Hey Peter, what's going on, buddy? Hope you're well. This is Corby Blind. Apologies once again for the thing that happened earlier on when I went into the other stream. Again, apologies for that. I really didn't want to offend anybody. Like I said at the time, I kind of just went in there assuming if somebody was playing a B-side that they'd already finished all of the A-sides, so my bad. How are you doing tonight, my man? I cannot get this timing down at all. It's like I did it that one time, and now I can't do it again. Such is the story of my life with this game. How? Good to hear you doing good though, buddy. Welcome along to the Nock stream. Oh, I pressed on the direction too early. I should have waited. If I'd have waited, that would have been a lot better. Whee! There we go. No, I appreciate it. I appreciate you stopping by and saying hi. Thank you very much. You enjoy the rest of your evening. Okay, so I think we've got to dream... do this up. And get through the gap. Ooh. Okay, so... bounce up, go through the gap, go off there, go through the other gap, go across to the right-hand side of that spike to then propel me across over there, I think is what I'm going to want to do. At first glance. It's going to be no good because I've got no dash left. Yeah, that's what I need to do. Wow, I almost got through there without even using a dash. Stop diagonaling. Oh, I dashed too early. I wasn't far enough over to grab. There's such a... stop myself. I pressed left. For some reason, I hesitated. If I hadn't have hesitated, I would have been through the gap there. Well, yeah, but I mean, after doing my like complete A-side run earlier on, though, I actually don't mind the bumpers too much now, actually. It's just getting through this gap here, which is the pitter. You had to say something, K7, didn't you, about these blocks and how that I was doing really well with them, didn't you? You just had to say it. Oh, man. I guess I need to kick off the walls. Excuse me. Tops of the blocks are slippy, aren't they? They're icy. Well, that's close. You looking forward to seasides? I am, and I'm not. Because I know that they're going to be... I'm looking forward to them because I know they're in like 3, 4, 5 screens, but. I'm not looking forward to them because of how intense they're going to be. Didn't jump out of that. Man, my inputs again. I need to get lower on that block before I grab it. My problem is I'm too high, and then when I get the momentum off the block, see, that wasn't enough. I didn't jump far enough off it that time. But my problem before has been I'm too high on the block, and I'm hitting the spikes because. Come on. So, to go back to last night, K7, I don't think you answered the question. If you did, I apologise. Have you changed your Twitch name? Because didn't it used to be something beginning with P? Oh man, totally butchered that. Oh! Okay. At least I'm not going crazy. What's going on, Rod? Welcome to the stream, buddy. How are you doing tonight? Whew, we're through. Go for the stamina. I was yesterday's face. Are you still doing the faces? Well, that was sucky. I think I prefer the ice parts. Something about them, you just seem to be able to like give. You seem to be able to like take that little bit of extra time, and especially you have like all these other jump things to jump on as well. I think with the fire, you have to be a lot more precise and a lot quicker with your actions. So. Sure, I mean, if you've got a link, then. You got anything you want to show me? You post that link in that chat, my man. More than happy to see it. What's going on, Dr. Keklan? Welcome along, buddy. How you doing tonight? Hope you're well. Still working on that portal map, or did you get it finished in the end? Oh, okay. I think that's what I gotta do. You still working on it? All right. These things take time. I appreciate that. Alright, so I've got to jump off that one and then go back. Five chambers in a map. Jeez, that's something. Just give me a second, Rod. Nice. I haven't heard any of the music for the DLC yet. TikTok, TikTok, TikTok. Nice. I like the art style. Very nice. Bit of a scaly guy going on here. Almost like a Two-Face kind of thing. Like a destroyed side and a nice side. That's nice. I like that, Rod. Keep up the good work, buddy. First turn is very easy and people will fly through them. It starts out stupidly easy and works its way up to somewhat more difficult. Okay, well, as I said to you previously, as and when you know you have something, I'll be more than happy to give it a go. Oh my god. Well, it take. I get. I think though, okay, Casey, so you say that, but I mean, I would love to make more maps than I do. But I think really all it comes down to is just finding that one bit of inspiration. If you can be inspired to make something by somebody or something, then I think you'll come up with something. Heck, my last map was, I got so inspired by Demon Arisen. He did a live stream map and making a map. And yeah, I just got really inspired. And I actually made probably what I consider to be my best map to date. I just grab a drink. Give me a sec, guys. And we're back. Heck, I still want to, my problem is, though, a lot of the time I have so many things that I'm interested in and I want to do. So there's like my DJing stuff. Then I'm trying to make a map in Hammer, and I have been for like a good couple of years now. I've been trying to do that. But I have all these ideas, but I just don't have time. At least we're, I'm making good progress with this starting section now. Oh man, I really wish this cough would just do one. I thought it was getting better, but then today it just seems like it's got progressively worse. Which is quite annoying, to say the least. Feels like I'm like got like a really dry cough now. But my coughs are like really pathetic. It's like I don't really feel like I need. I don't feel like I should be coughing. I can't like. Weird to say, but it's always like I don't justify coughing because it's so weak and pathetic. But I just have to cough. I know, people like Fumbly, a Sears, Paper, all those people just like churn maps out like there's no tomorrow. I didn't jump off that guy. Wait a minute. Your Steam Deck is 7 silhouette? Jeez! Why don't you tell me sooner, man? You've been hanging around my streams for like months! And I had no idea. Jeez. Oh dear. Oh, what's going on, buddy? Yeah, this is I feel like my consistency, like getting that door token, is the big downfall here at the minute. I don't know, the sequence just seems to be different. I don't know why. It's like before I was hitting that one as it come through the spikes, but now I'm not doing anything. There we go. I've got to hit that bumper like dead on the center, or else I'm just toasting to the spikes. I think it's hitting that one, isn't it? I knew the minute I went for that bumper, I wasn't going to pull it off. Certain Mr. 808 is trying to lure me away to play some worms, but I'm not going just yet. Yeah, that's quite nice. I don't think I'm jumping off that one enough. I definitely didn't jump off that. Okay. I think what I tried to do there was hang back a little bit more. I think that kind of worked a bit better. But I need to remember to jump off that one. So that's what I'm not doing. The thing is, though, this is like a hardcore platformer, so 9 times out of 10, the platformer would be a lot easier than this game. This is kind of like your equivalent of Super Meat Boy. I guess this is going to be tonight's stream's final boss. I'm not getting no height anymore off that. I'm not getting any height now off this, like, that one. I can't seem to clear the spikes anymore. I don't know why. That works. Yeah, I'm trying to hold jump after hitting it. Maybe I'm not. But now, I'm not. But now I'm getting down there too early because I'm skipping out a lot of the blocks. Know what I hit there. Ow! I caught the dash. If I could just consistently, if at the minute I could just consistently get to that bumper and practice what I'm going to do with the bumper, then if I'd have just dashed up, my troubles would seem so far away. But alas, they're here to stay. So close. Do you mean like that, K7? I'm happy with this though, because we're getting to try something new. We're trying something new, rather than doing the same thing over and over again. He says, no, I can't get over the freaking first spike block. Feel myself, like, my face and everything just like tensing up. I feel like I'm doing like proper concentration faces. I've lost my rhythm now. Get a jump off that last one. Woo! Sorry, I had to clear my snout. Okay. Oh, yeah, okay. All right. Oh my goodness, have you seen the gap? They expect me to get through there. So what? Hold on. I kind of did like a wall kick. All right. Why am I... This is bizarre. This is bizarre. I'm doing the diagonal, but then... I'm letting go of the diagonal? There we go. Oh man. I haven't got enough though, K7. Oh, okay. I apologize. Maybe I have. I take it back. That's just me and my fat-fingered inputs, which thought that it wouldn't work. Yeah, I don't think this room's particularly difficult. Thanks for stopping by, buddy. I appreciate it, and make sure you get that map request into me as soon as that map's ready. I get enough height apart from the one time where I actually need it. All of the other times, I didn't particularly need it. Now I'm hitting my head on the wall. Jeez. This room is not difficult. I just cannot seem to get through this gap now. This is frustrating me now because it's like I don't understand how this mechanic works when I get to that one side. I'm not getting any height, and it's I think I'm jumping too early. That's why I'm not getting any height. But then I left it a bit later there and still got no height. Do I've run out of stamina? I either get not enough hype or too much. I can't seem to find the middle ground consistently. I don't understand why I'm having such a hard time with this one jump. I don't get it. Another option. Oh man, I'm so bunged up. Okay, I like this option better. Sorry, I don't mean to sound all snotty and horrible. I just need to... Well look, at the end of the day... Getting stuck now at a different section, so I call that progress. I don't know about you, but I've also got a second dash in hand there if I actually want to dash first. I can't grab the gem before Why did I... What did I do wrong there? That just confused me. That moment where you think you've worked out the strat and then you can't then pull it off. That's not gonna work, is it? Also, keep hitting my thumb on the other side of the table. I was getting concerned there because I knew I was going to, if I don't soon get that gem, I was going to run out of stamina. Timing on this second jump, or second dash. I think I got to do it from the right hand side. I totally forgot my strategy there. Fractionally late with that second dash. Didn't even dash there, but it's going to be hard to pull that move off at the second part. I'm going to go for a different strat, I think, on this second one, though. If I ever get there to give it a go. Way too late. Right, then diagonal up. Mr. Dash. Regen. Seems like when the pressure's on, I just cannot get off this block. It's like in that practice bit where I'm like going from side to side, not a problem. I jump off it every time. But then that third jump off here, is where it all goes wrong. The one point it really matters to get it right. And dash through it. You see, the problem is, because I'm so inconsistent. Hold on. There could be an easier strat here. Going to confuse matters. I had a bit of a mind blank there. I thought for some reason I was had a dash going over to here. So my backup that I was thinking was, or my other strat was, I have two dashes to use. So if it didn't get enough height, maybe I can dash up before I dash right, but I think it's too close quartered. As in, it's too close to each other for me to pull off. Something like that. I'd much rather do it as like one foul swoop and get the positioning right off this thing here. I totally wasn't concentrating there at all. Yeah. Mainly the third one. Yeah, and I've gone back to probably what's the shorter strat as well. I think what difficulty I'm having with this bit here is I think the reason I'm not getting high is because of the change of direction. I'm doing something with my inputs. So that I have, it's like false hope. I have a couple of good runs. So I think, oh, I know, let's swap the strat and we'll do it the other way. But then I have no consistency. And now I go back to why I chose the alternative route for a start, because I can't get any height off this right-hand side. Looking at the inputs there, just back on the stream, I'm doing a diagonal, so I don't know why. Try grabbing it as low as possible. Alright, gotcha. That helps. My only concern, though, is that if I get too much height again. So if I get too much height, it's a balancing act. The same again there, I just gotta grab it lower. Yeah, you see, now I've got the problem where I'm getting too much. I just feel like I'm not getting the same amount of height. Man, this is a long room. I didn't expect it to be a third section. So what's the directional input on the third section then? Probably longer than you remember, because I've been on this freaking room for so long. I don't know why it's so difficult to get the height off that right hand side. How long have I been going? Do you know how long I've been going at this room for? Was I at this point when I went to get my beverage? No, so it's an hour since I went to get a drink, so I've been on this for quite some time. Alright. Let's try something else. Let's see if we get ourselves a one-up. That's a bit of a change of scenery. Okay. So, to get the one up, we need to get, I think it's 5 strawberries. Oh, man. Alright, well. This isn't going to plan at the minute, is it? It's a thing you never tried? It's difficult, though, because you obviously you can't stay on the ground for too long. So... How did I... how did that... I don't understand how one of the strawberries was... Ah! Yeah, just gotta move really quick. Didn't move quick enough. Oh, fish dicks. It's alright though, because we didn't What's going on, Deathwish? Die, die, die! I'm not dying, I'm just touching the ground. I'm not going to touch the ground for more than like a millisecond. Floor is lava, and all that sort of jazz. Oh, I need more than... What? I need more than five? Really? Alright, let's work out where I can get another strawberry from them. I'm not going for that one. I was, but I haven't been feeling too... Well, I say I haven't been feeling too good. My cough seems to have come back today, which is rather annoying, to say the least. Alright, where is this guy getting this other one from? Let's have a look. Yeah. Wow, that's some good editing right there. Oh, there it is. Okay. Right. Oh, I was trying to do what he did, but or that person did, but I think I'll just stick to my strap because I'm gonna lose that strawberry or not. Every other time, I completely missed that. What did you miss on that last one? Which one? One of the strawberries, I touched the ground for too long and one of the strawberries stopped following me. Probably what you're referring to. Obviously, if I die, I lose any strawberries that I've collected but haven't claimed yet, so I have to restart. Oh, man. Excuse me. It's a website actually, Devwish, that I don't know how it works. It must work on like some sort of JavaScript or something, but yeah. It It's just an OBS browser source to a website. Sorry, my brain's a bit mushy at the minute. Played too much Celeste tonight. Well, not tonight, but today in general. But yeah, it's just a free website you go to. You can like customize the look of your control in different bits and pieces. So if I wanted to display it as an Xbox 360 control, I could use that as well. So okay. No! I just think in these sorts of games, it's quite handy to, for instance, when I'm going through levels and I'm moaning and complaining that things can't be done, or I'm not getting what I expect to be happening on the inputs, like chat can tell me, actually, Nock, you fat fingered it, or I can actually go back in the video afterwards and take a look to see what actually I went wrong and did wrong. So it's nice. Of course, the one I really need is like one for my keyboard, so that I can prove to you once and for all, though, that my spacebar doesn't work. Spacebar is a king and always works. All right, I'll have a couple more attempts and then I think I'll call it a day for tonight. A day for tonight. Well, that's kind of contradictory, isn't it? No! It's such an easy key to use, though, isn't it, in games, I suppose, because it's so big. Plus, most games chuck jump on a space bar, so. No. Alright, so I really need to like learn how to do this room, I guess. It's not really a room that I come through a lot in the game, so grab it. Grab it. Come back. Space bar meat boy. I don't know why I said space bar me boy, I totally misread what you was typing there. I just assumed. We was talking about space bar. I saw a word beginning with S and instantly assumed you were saying space bar meat boy. Why on earth you would say space bar meat boy, I have no idea. Ow. Damn them winged strawberries. Ow, that's exactly what I don't want to happen. All right, I'm done tonight because I have played so much Celeste today. My fingers are killing. I've played probably about 5 hours of Celeste today, having put together my speedrun earlier on. So yeah, we didn't get to finish core, unfortunately, tonight. Have a look at this for Insanity Deathwish. Have a look at this for like super hardcore insanity. This is why I tried to do something else, because I just cannot pull off this move and this jump in this room. I was probably on this trying to do this for like about the part of an hour. I just cannot get over there, and I just think my fingers are just so tired. But yeah. These rooms be crazy. Let me take a... Let me go grab a picture before I finish up for the screenshot. While I'm doing that, thank you very much everybody for tuning in to my last stream as a 33-year-old. Next time I'm streaming, we will be another year older. But yeah, thanks everybody for tuning in, sticking around, and for the support as always. Appreciate it. We'll be back on Monday night with some more Celeste. Maybe we'll be able to finish off core. But until then, guys, thank you very much. I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.